good there, Bear Scouts. Looking very good.
Welcome to Sesame Street.
Yeah. You're just in time for a very important Bear Scout meeting. It's moving up day.
Yes.
And Papa Bear was just about to inspect our bear badges. Mm-hmm. That's these babies right here.
Yeah. We get these badges for doing bear type of things. See?
That's right. And as your Bear Scout leader, it is my job to see that you've earned all of your Bear Scout badges that you need to move up in the ranks.
Yeah, see, we're just Bear Scout cubs now. But if we have all of our badges, then today we can move up to Bear Scout Grizzlies.
Oh, dare to dream.
Well, Scouts, you've worked very hard to earn these badges. I hope you all move up to Grizzly status. Now let's see what you've got. Well, Paul, looks like you got your honey tasting, tree climbing, fish catching, porridge appreciation, bear hugs, and camping out like a bear. Congratulations, Paul! You're now a Bear Scout Grizzly.
Yes!
There you go.
Hey, go, Paul!
There you go, Paul!
Yes.
All right, moving right along to Rosita. Rosita, do you think you've got what it takes to be a grizzly?
Yes, sir. I hope so, sir.
Let's see. Honey tasting, tree climbing, fish catching, porridge appreciation, camping out like a bear, bear hug, bear hug, bear hug, bear hug, bear hug, bear hug. Whoa, you sure got a lot of these badges. Well, that's all of them. Congratulations! You are our second grizzly!
Thank you, sir!
Yep. You really perfected that bear hug! Woo! Okay, Telly, it's your turn. Let's see if you got all of your bear badges.
I'm so nervous.
Let's see. You got your honey tasting, tree climbing, fish catching, porridge appreciation, bear hugging. Uh-oh, there appears to be a problem.
Problem? What problem?
Well, you don't have a camping out like a bear badge.
Oh no, I completely forgot that I needed that one.
You forgot? How could you forget something like that, Telly?
Come to think of it, you don't have that badge either, baby bear.
What? Ah, it's true! I never earned my camping out like a bear badge! Oh, this is a tragic oversight!
You have never camped out like a bear? But you are an actual bear, baby bear!
I know, but I'm a civilized bear. I live in a house. I've never camped out outside like a bear before. What an ironic twist of fate!
Well, I'm sorry, boys, but I can't move you up to Grizzlies without those badges.
Oh, no. I've dreamed of becoming a grizzly for so long, and now all my dreams shattered.
Oh, cruel fate. Why do you mock me?
Now, calm down, boys. This is a problem, but I know how we can solve it.
You do?
How?
All you have to do to get those badges is camp out for one night. So, we'll camp out at Mount Bear. Tonight!
Tonight?
That's a great idea, Papa Bear.
Yeah! Then you can get your camping out like a bear badges, and we can all be grizzlies.
Yeah!
Come on, son! Let's go home and pack our things for the big camp out!
Yes!
Yeah.
See you later, Telly!
Bye!
Come on!
What's the matter, Telly?
Well, Rosita, yeah? I've never camped out before. What if I get scared?
Oh, don't worry, Telly. You're going to have a great time.
Okay, dear, we're all ready to start on our camping trip.
But first, we have to load up our camping van. Here's our equipment checklist. Tent,
Tent.
Clothing.
Clothing.
Sleeping bags.
Sleeping bags.
Food.
Food.
Fishing rod.
Fishing rod.
Bone.
A bone.
You lost? You can't be from around here.
Skeek!
Hi, Skeeks. Well, don't you worry. That's what I'm here for. Rescue people all the time. Stuck up high on top of my mountain. I love saving you guys. Take you down. Get you down to the valley. All the way down. Well, look. Past the little stream of melted snow. And we're still high up on the mountain, you know. Down and down, where the trees start growing and the stream gets larger. Ooh, there's a waterfall. Goes to the river and past the meadow. Down, down. See? There's the river. Comes from melting snow, you know. And here's the valley. Got you all the way down to the foot of the big mountain. Well, where to now, little guy?
Ski!
Just one more knot. There we go.
Wow, we did it. The tents look great. Yeah. Don't the tents look great, Telly?
Yeah, great.
Now, Bear Scouts, what do you say we get a nice campfire going?
Oh, why, you got it, Papa Bear, Scoutmaster, sir.
Okay, everybody, look around and gather some wood for the fire.
Okay.
Where?
Oh, boy. This is great. Oh, there's one.
Get one.
You see, Tally, isn't camping out fun?
I don't know, baby bear. I'm starting to feel a little scared.
What are you scared of?
That something might scare me out here.
Wait a second. Let me get this straight here. You're scared that something might scare you?
Right.
Tally, listen to yourself. You got, like, layers and layers of fear.
I know.
But you can't live your life this way, you know? You gotta let go of the fear, you know? You gotta relax. You're out here in nature. Enjoy yourself.
Yeah, but what if there's wild animals out here in nature?
What, you mean like chipmunks and squirrels and birds?
No. I mean scary wild animals like lions or tigers or bears. Oh, my.
Tally, we are here on Mount Bear. Yeah. It's not very far from the city. There are no lions or tigers out here. Although, there are a few bears.
Bears? Bears?
And a monster.
A monster? There are bears and a monster on Mount Bear?
Tally.
We gotta get out of here. What if the monster and the bears come to our campsite? Come on, I'll cover for
Tally,
you.
Tally, I got my stick here. The bears and the monsters, they're already here.
They're already here. Where?
Tally, get a grip here, buddy. You are the monster. And Papa Bear and I are the bears.
You're the bear.
I'm the bear.
You're the bear.
You're the monster.
I'm a big monster.
Oh, yeah. So you see, Tally, there is nothing to be afraid of.
Yeah, well, you might be right about that.
All right, so let's go get some firewood. Okay?
Hey, I got a piece.
Oh, that's a good one. Let me get one. Whoa.
Yeah. Come on, over this way. Okay. There's more.
Monster in the mirror when I woke up today. A monster in my mirror, but I did not run away. I did not shed a tear or hide beneath my bed. Though the monster looked at me, and this is what he said. He said, wubba, 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 woo, woo, woo. Wubba, 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 and a doodly doo. He sang, wubba, 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 so I sang it too. Me or I will wubba you.
Do not wubba me or I will wubba you.
Told the monster in the mirror, no, I am not scared. Then I smiled at him and thanked him for the song that we had shared. Well, the monster thanked me too, he smiled right back, and then the monster in the mirror sang his song again. He sang wubba 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 woo woo woo. Wubba, 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 and a doodly-doo. He went wubba, 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 and I sang along. This wubba, wubba, wubba is a monster song.
Wubba, wubba, wubba is a monster song.
Wubba, 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 woo-woo-woo.
Wubba, 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 and a doodly-doo.
He went wubba, 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 and I sang along.
Monster song.
Wubba 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 is a monster song. Wubba 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 woo woo woo. Wubba 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 and a dilly doo.
He say wubba 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 and sing along. Wubba 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 is a monster song. Wubba 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 is a monster song.
If your mirror has a monster in it, do not shout. This kind of situation does not call for freaking out. And do nothing that you would not like to see him do. Cause that monster in the mirror, he just might be you. Singing wubba 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 woo woo woo. Wubba 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 and a doodly doo. Wubba wubba wubba, you can join in too.
Wubba 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 wubba.
If you wubba me, then I will wubba you.
If you wubba me, then I will wubba you.
The Yes, if you wubba me, then I will wubba you.
If you wubba me, then I will wubba you.
Going wubba, wubba, wubba is the thing to do.
Every time you wubba us, we'll wubba you.
Hey, wubba, man.
Bird!
Yellow yams and yogurt? Because they're yummy. Why? Yak. Why?
Nice fire, Papa Bear. It's very cozy.
Thanks, son. How are you doing, Telly? Is anything feeling scary to you at all?
No, not yet. So far, I'm actually having a pretty good time.
Well, I knew you would, Telly.
Yeah, but I still have the feeling that something's gonna scare me tonight.
Something like what?
I don't know. I never camped out before. I don't know what to expect.
Well, there's really nothing to be scared of. We're just gonna sit around the campfire, eat some food, sing a few songs, roast some marshmallows.
I like doing those things.
Yeah, and then we'll sleep in the tents, and maybe tomorrow we can do some hiking and some fishing.
I like doing all of those things, too. Gee, maybe camping won't be so scary after all. Maybe it'll even be fun.
That's right, Telly. But you know the very best part of camping out? Just being out here, in the great outdoors. There's nothing like communing with nature. Breathing that clean air. Getting back to our roots.
Yeah, you know, it makes me feel really bearish.
Yeah, I think I know what you mean. I feel like I belong here, like I'm one with the earth.
Now you got the right idea. Let me tell you boys a story.
When I was just a wee little bear, no bigger than you or you, my papa took me camping the way bears sometimes do. He taught me how to sleep outside, out in the fresh, clean air. He taught me about nature and what it means to be a bear. And now when I go camping, I still feel a certain way. I'll tell you what that feeling is, though it might sound cliche. I'm a happy camper. I love to camp outside. To be so close to nature fills me up with pride. It warms my heart to be a part of Earth's big family. Yes, I'm a happy camper, and I will always be.
Okay, campers, sing with me.
Oh,
love to camp outside. To be so close to nature fills us up with pride. It warms our heart to be a part of Earth's big family. Yes, we are happy campers, and we will always be. Yes, we are happy campers, and we will always be.
Man, I really feel relaxed now.
Oh, I'm glad to hear it, Telly. Oh, gee, we were having so much fun singing, I didn't even notice it got dark out.
Yeah. Yeah, it is getting very dark out here. Very, very dark.
Oh, boy, this is so exciting.
Okay, time to go home. Let's pack it up and move it out.
Go home? We don't have to go home, Baby Bear. I'm not scared at all.
No, but I am.
He's scared?
Well, he did not look like a happy camper. Wait up, son!
I used to be afraid of the dark, of things I thought were there. These things that I imagined would give me quite a scare. Now I sing a silly song, and they will join right in. For we've become quite special friends. They always make me grin.
At night, sometimes when I have to go to sleep, I get really scared. My daddy brought me back in the room. It was really scary in there. I showed him all those sounds. He said all I had to do was use my imagination.
Okay.
My dad has the best ideas.
Bert? Hey, Bert. Bert?
Mm-hmm. Honey, what is it? I'm trying to sleep.
Hey, Bert, did you ever think about all the things you like?
Well, sure, Ernie, but not now, huh?
Hey, but just tell me something you like, Bert.
Well, Ernie, I'm trying to sleep.
Oh, come on, Bert. Just one. Just name one thing that you like, okay? Name just one.
Oh, all right, Ernie. I'll try. I like paper clips.
Paper clips?
Paper clips. I like bottle caps.
Bottle caps.
Bottle caps. I love pigeons, yeah.
Pigeons?
Love pigeons. Oh, yes, I do.
Well, Bert, you know, I don't really like any of those things, but I like you.
Arnie.
I like playing jokes.
Playing jokes.
Playing jokes. Love my rubber duck.
Rubber duck.
Rubber ducky. I like bubble gum.
Bubble gum.
Bubble gum. Yes, I do.
Well, now, Ernie, I'm not crazy about any of those things, but I like you.
like to lie awake in bed at night and talk to you.
Yeah, I know. I like to say goodnight and go to sleep.
I like to go and see the big hippopotamus in the zoo.
Ernie, you know what?
What, Bert?
I like that too.
Gee,
I like jelly beans.
Jelly beans?
Jelly beans.
I like lentil soup.
Lentil soup.
Yeah, I like a marching band.
I like a music box.
Yes, I do.
But though I don't always like everything
that I like,
still I like you.
Though I'm not too crazy about your rubber ducky,
though I don't love pigeons, still we're awfully lucky, 'cause I like you.
Bear, what's the matter? Why are you so scared?
Why? Have you looked around, Telly? It's dark out here, and it's getting darker by the minute. I'm not sticking around here any longer. I'm going home.
But, son, I don't understand. I thought you wanted to camp out.
Camp out? Yes. In the pitch black, scary dark? No.
But didn't you know it was going to get dark out here at night?
Well, yeah, sure. I knew it was gonna get dark. I just didn't expect to be afraid of the dark. But guess what? I am! Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm trying to pack you. Here's my stuff.
But if you go home, then you won't get your camping out like a bear badge. And then you can't become a Bear Scout Grizzly.
Oh, yeah. That's right! I don't know what to do. Part of me wants to stay so I can become a grizzly. But part of me is scared and wants to go home. I'm so conflicted.
Well, son, look, I'll tell you what. If you want to, and only if you want to, we could stay here a little while and see if you get used to the dark. We'll just give it a chance. And after that, if you still want to go home, we can all go home together.
Really?
Really?
And Baby Bear, you can borrow Freddy if you want to. He's really good for hugging when you're scared.
Oh.
Here.
Thanks, Telly.
Now why don't we just sit around the campfire and try to relax?
Yeah. Okay, Papa Bear. I'll try.
There, son. Everything's gonna be all right.
Sure is relaxing out here. So quiet, so peaceful.
What is that? What's that sound?
I don't know. What is that sound, Papa Bear?
Let me listen close. Oh, it's an owl, that's all.
Oh, an owl? I almost fainted from that owl.
Just try to relax, Baby Bear.
What is that? What is that sound?
Gee, I don't know that sound either.
Sounds like a bullfrog to me.
A bullfrog? That's a pretty scary sounding bullfrog. Ah! What is that? What is that sound?
I don't know. Papa Bear?
It's just the crickets chirping.
Oh, yeah. Right. Relax, Baby Bear, relax.
How am I supposed to relax with all this noise out here? I can't take this. Oh, I'm so tense. Ah! What is that? Is the worst sound of all? What is that sound, Papa Bill?
I don't know what that sound was. In all my years of camping experience, I've never heard a sound like that.
I know what it was.
Tally, is that sound coming from you?
Yeah, it's my stomach rumbling. I'm hungry. Do you think we could have something to eat now?
Good idea. Let's get our sandwiches.
Yeah, yeah. Anything to stop that racket. PLTs, porridge, lettuce, and tomato. Delicious.
Rocking since this morning, time to break for lunch. Thought I'd have a sandwich, but man, there's such a bunch. There's 18, and I don't know what I want. 18, I can't decide what I want. There's tuna, turkey, peanut butter, grilled cheese, or salami. Ham or jelly, chicken salad, chopped liver.
Glasses. 18. Chairs. 18 socks. 18.
18. 18.
Evening in the swamp. My favorite time. I love to just sit in the quiet and listen. And one by one, I begin to hear all the little sounds around me. Hear that? That's the sound of water dripping from a leaf into a puddle. And you know, the longer I sit here, the more sounds I hear.
When I listen in the quiet of the evening, what do I hear? Water dripping, dripping in the quiet of the evening. When I listen in the quiet of the evening, what do I hear? Crickets chirping, chirping in the quiet of the evening. I hear a bullfrog croaking all night long. My Uncle Ben, a hoot owl, hooting his evening song. I'm so happy to be near them. It's so restful just to hear them when I listen in the quiet of the evening. I hear a mockingbird singing on the hill. His song is sweeter when everything is still. When I listen in the quiet of the evening, what do I hear? Dogs bow-wowing. What do I hear? Cats meowing. Brown bears snoring. Tigers roaring. Oh, it's the sound of Mother Nature murmuring low.
Let yourself go.
When I listen in the quiet of the evening.
This is the loudest quiet I've ever listened to. Will you guys keep it down? Somebody's trying to sing out here. I'm gonna go find me a quiet swamp.
Nothing scares me anymore, not since I met Eleanor. Eleanor's a creature that would peep from under my bed when I would sleep. I'd get tucked in, say goodnight, and then they'd always douse the lights. While in the dark beneath my bed, I'd imagine things that fed on tips of fingers, bits of toes, socks and slippers, underclothes, anything that hung below my pillow. And I would lie there like a board, scared to pieces of the floor. And then one night, I don't remember when, I had the nerve to face my fright. I got on my knees, looked under my bed. The thing that was scary was all in my head. So now when I'm sleepy and I'm all tucked in, I imagine the creature down there is my friend. I gave her a name, Eleanor. And I'm not afraid anymore. Good night.
Boy, those sandwiches sure hit the spot.
Yeah.
It seems to be getting darker. Oh, this is too much for a wee little bear to bear. Papa Bear, I gave it a chance, but now I really want to go home.
All right then, Baby Bear. If you're this frightened, we can go home. Let's just pack it in.
Okay. Telly, is it okay with you if we go home?
Sure, Baby Bear.
Really? Mm-hmm. Even though it means that we won't get our camping out like a bear badges? And then we can't become grizzlies?
It's okay. I mean, I do really want to become a Bear Scout grizzly, but not without you. You're my best friend, and we will stick together.
Oh, thanks, Telly. You know, that means a lot to me.
Well, I know what it's like to be scared. I mean, who you're talking to. But I'm just kind of surprised that you're afraid of the dark, Baby Bear.
I know, I'm surprised too. But I'm not just scared. I'm terrified. The dark is so dark. I can't see anything. There's no light anywhere.
Actually, there's quite a lot of light out here, son. Look at our campfire, for instance. The fire makes a nice warm orange light.
Oh, yeah, I suppose that's true.
Mm-hmm. And look around you. What are all those little blinking lights flying around?
Hey, lightning bugs!
That's right. Tiny little bugs that give off light.
Wow, look at them.
They're so cool.
Ooh, and look up at the sky. See all the lights up there?
Oh, wow! The stars! They're beautiful! And there's so many wee little twinkling lights!
Billions and billions of them!
And what about that big light over there?
The moon!
That's where Slimy went!
Wow, the moon is so big and beautiful! And it's really bright. There's a lot of light coming from that moon.
You see, Baby Bear? The dark isn't so dark after all.
You know, I guess you're right.
And just think, if it wasn't dark out, we wouldn't be able to see the stars, or the moon, or the lightning bugs.
Wow, you know, I never thought of that.
Are you feeling less afraid, Baby Bear?
Well, a little bit. But even though there's all these lights out here, there's still a lot of darkness, too.
Well, there is something you can use to make some more light, and you brought it with you.
Hey, my flashlight!
Mm-hmm. Now you can have light whenever you want it.
Yeah, I just point the flashlight where I want the light to be. Like there's Telly.
Ah, thank you.
And there's Papa Bear.
Uh-huh.
And there's Baby Bear.
Yeah.
And there's the tent over there.
Uh-huh.
This is great.
Yeah. So, do you still want to go home, son?
You know, to tell you the truth, I'm not all that scared anymore. I have the moon. I have the stars. I have the lightning bugs. I have the campfire. I have my flashlight. I have seen the lights. I'm a happy camper again. We're staying.
Yeah!
All right!
Now let's go and do some camping.
Noodles and Ned.
Samantha?
Yes?
I have some moon questions for you.
Okay.
Okay? If we go to the moon, how long do you think it will take us to get there?
About, maybe 10 miles.
10 miles. Okay. And when we get to the moon, what do you think would be up there?
I think there'd be weird-looking creatures, sort of like alien creatures,
mm-hmm.
and they have big black eyes, and their little tiny nose, no ears, and they have hands and arms and a body, but they wear no clothes. They might not.
Hey, I have an idea.
What?
Let's pretend you and I are in a rocket ship.
Okay.
Going to the moon. Okay? You want to drive?
Okay.
Okay, you drive. Oh, we have to have a countdown. Can you count down from 10 to 1?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Ready? And countdown!
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Blast off! Okay, drive, drive, drive. Careful for that star over there. Watch out for that astronaut. Okay, okay. Okay, take me to the moon, okay? Are we there yet?
Yeah.
Are we landed?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get out to the moon. Let's look around, look around. What do you see?
I see weird alien creatures,
yeah?
And they're having an alien cake.
An alien cake?
Yeah, and they're eating some good alien cake with a cherry on top.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Is it a birthday party for aliens?
Yeah, it might be one of their alien birthdays.
Yeah. Then what should we do? Should we look around the moon?
Okay.
Okay. You lead the way. I'm scared. What do you see?
I see a few little baby aliens driving in the car to the alien birthday party.
Oh, this is fun. You know, I have to get home soon. Should we go back to the spaceship?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, let's take this home. Ready? Blast off! Okay. Okay, take it. Okay. Okay, now land the ship home. Is it landed?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Oh, you're a wonderful astronaut driver person thing. Yes, that was fun. Thank you for taking us to the moon. You know what?
What?
Look up there. We were in the moon. Right on the moon.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take away 1, leaves 4. 4, take away 2, leaves 2. 2, take away 1, leaves 1. 1, take away 1, leaves none.
Gosh, sky sure looks beautiful tonight, Mr. Bennett.
Oh, it sure does, Big Bird. All the twinkling stars and that wonderful moon.
Yeah, and just think, Slimy flew all the way to the moon in his spaceship. He must be a very brave worm.
Oh, he sure is. To go off chasing moonbeams, a worm needs to be nervy. He needs guts and stickability. When things go topsy-turvy, to embark on a worm moon mission, a worm really needs the right stuff, like a powerful rocket ignition or some timely assistance from snuff. Slimy to the moon, he wants to wriggle amongst the stars. Let him crawl through mud and muck on Jupiter or Mars. To other worlds, let him fly. To other worlds, send him winging. Slimy to the moon, and when this worm arrives, you'll find he'll take a leap that's small for him, but huge for all wormkind. To other worlds, he will soar. To other worlds, and then home to us once more.
Why? The letter Y.
And now it's time for Worms in Space with our worm astronauts. 5 very brave, very smart, very cute little worms. Today, we ask the question, can worms make the letter Y in space? The worms will now try to make the letter Y. Can they do it? We can only watch and wait. Oh, they missed. But it looks like, yes, they're going to try again. What courage, what strength, what wiggling. Yes. Oh, they did it. They made the capital letter Y. What's this, folks? Why, the worms are making a lowercase y, too. The answer to our question is yes, worms can make the letter Y in space. Another spectacular triumph for our 5 very brave, very smart, very cute little worm.
Hello. Today, me here in local bakery here to talk about a word. Important. Yeah, when something is important, it means whole lot to you. For instance, look over here. See, take this oatmeal cookie. It's important. It means whole lot to me. Ah, nom, 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 boy. Oh, a chocolate chip cookie. chocolate chip cookie important to me, too. Yeah, I mean, whole lot to me. Important. But me not want to make this butter cookie feel bad. Oh, yeah, it's important, too. Oh, and this gingerbread cookie, very important, too. In fact, all cookies, very important to me. They mean a lot to me, but they mean much more to me tummy. Cowabunga! Cookie!
Look at them sleeping. They were very brave camping out here tonight. I am really proud of them. They've truly earned these. Camping out like a bear badges. Yeah. Here you go, Telly. Here you go, baby bear. Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter Y and by the number 18. And Slimy Spaceship is still on its way back to Sesame Street. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Good night, little Grizzlies.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.